on Hurricane Gustav, which is approaching western Cuba and could hit the U.S. Gulf Coast late Monday or early Tuesday. Now, landfall is predicted anywhere from Galveston, Texas to Mobile, Alabama. So there's a large cone of uncertainty there. New Orleans, though, is in the center of what's called that cone of uncertainty that I spoke of, and some people are already leaving that city. Lines are forming at evacuation centers. You're looking at some of that now. Traffic is heavy on Interstate 55, which is a major route out of New Orleans. In Belle Chasse, Louisiana, mandatory evacuations begin in about 90 minutes.
Well, the U.S. military also gearing up to help out. We are joined now by General Renuart, who joins us now from Colorado Springs, Colorado. Sir, we appreciate you giving us some time today. Are you all taking a proactive role instead of a reactive, and what are you doing right now?
Well, we certainly are, and it's great to be with you this morning. As you know, we learned a lot of lessons out of Hurricane Katrina, and we have put those to good use in preparation for this storm. I have to compliment Governor Jindal and his team in the state of Louisiana for their forward-leaning preparation. As you've mentioned, we have begun evacuations already. And for our purposes, the U.S. Northern Command is coordinating very closely with the National Guard and with FEMA, as well as the states, to be supportive in these evacuation processes.
And you say supportive. I guess who is responsible, if you will? We have the National Guard there helping out and so many other resources and agencies. You all specifically, are you there just as support, or do you actually have an active hand in getting those people out of there?
No, actually, we are very, very much engaged. There is a three-pronged evacuation plan that we have coordinated with the state and with FEMA, both rail, by the roadway, as you've mentioned, and via air. And as a matter of fact, today we have medical evacuation teams on the ground in Lake Charles, Louisiana, and in New Orleans, preparing to move critical care medical patients out of the area. We are also in the process. In fact, as we speak, there are aircraft on the ground in New Orleans to begin to move the general population out of that area to selected sites around the southeast, and we could move up to 16,000 of those folks.
Wow. Sir, how are you all going about targeting the areas where the need is greatest? Because we talk about that cone of uncertainty with this storm. We have a general idea, but we know these things are unpredictable. It sounds like from some of the things you're saying, talking about Louisiana, that you're targeting that area, but are you also putting resources in places and helping people out throughout the Gulf Coast?
Oh, absolutely, and you're right. Mother Nature gets the final vote on this, so we're working closely with Louisiana, for sure, but also with Mississippi and Texas. And I mentioned medical evacuation. We're also putting teams in place in Beaumont, Texas, to assist the state of Texas in moving some of its most critical patients out of that potential area of danger. So this is across the southeast, from Florida all the way to Texas, and in each state we have a good sense of the requirements they have and how DOD might be supportive.
All right, well, General Renuart, sir, we appreciate your time, and we appreciate the efforts as well. I know a lot of other people do. We've been hearing from our people on the ground, and certainly a lot of people are noticing right now that this is in stark contrast, at least this proactive movement, as you described, certainly in stark contrast to what we saw several years ago with Katrina. So that is certainly a good thing. So, Gene Renuart, sir, thank you so much for your time, and good luck to you today, all right, and through the weekend.
Thank you very much. Our pleasure.
All right, here's a reality check on Gustav. It has already killed 78 people in the Caribbean and caused a whole lot of destruction. You know, we've been getting a number of eye reports from you, and our Josh Leves has been looking over them, especially as we sit here watching that cone of uncertainty, waiting to see when and where Gustav is going to hit.
Yeah, and what it'll be like by the time it does. And absolutely, this is something the United States, parts of the U.S. obviously, are bracing for. It could hit really hard, and the people who know what it's been like include our eye reporters who have sent us some stuff. I'm doing something a little different here. See this pretty picture behind me? This is calm before the storm in Jamaica. Now we're going to go from this to the video we have of Gustav's arrival. This is some power. powerful stuff. It's coming to us from Castell Johnson. This is in St. Elizabeth. You can hear the sound there. Woo! This is St. Elizabeth, Jamaica. That's in the southwestern section of Jamaica, this area that was really slammed pretty hard. But I'll also tell you, Castell Johnson tells us that this is not one of the worst storms she's ever seen. Jamaica does get hit. But as we do know from officials there, four people did die in Jamaica. More people live in Kingston. I want to bring you over to those photos now right there. We have some iReport photos that were sent to us from Sonia Fuller, who watched this crash through in Kingston. And she tells us that she actually saw people lose their homes, parts of the area really devastated there. Some people staying in shelters, still recovering. I'm going to emphasize before I tell you anything else, no one went to danger to take these videos or these photos. We screen for that. If you happen to have pictures in a safe way, send them to us at iReport.com. And quickly, I'll show you the screen behind me. This is where we have some of the latest that you can get. First of all, you can submit your photos, iReport.com. You don't have to be a techno wizard. We'll show you how to do it. I also want to show you what we've got at CNN.com, because this brings it home. This is a Associated Press photography of people in Louisiana trying to get prepared right now. And I know we're about to get the latest on the weather. I want to let you know, if you're on the go, if you're not near a TV, we've actually set something up where we're taking the projected path, putting it for you right here. It's part of the main story at CNN.com. This keeps getting updated every time our Reynolds Wolf tells us what the latest is. So if you're not near a TV, go for that. But if you are, obviously, pay attention to Reynolds. And there you go. In fact, I think he's coming up. Reynolds?
Yeah, let's talk to him right now. Reynolds, great. As we talk about Gustav and we wait for it, where is it right now and how strong is it getting?
This is a very strong storm. I mean, it's a major hurricane. You've got maximum sustained winds of 125 miles. Some gusts have been stronger, approaching 150, 155. It is moving northwest at 14 miles an hour. It is expected to continue its trek to the northwest. It might be crossing over just the path, let's say extreme western Cuba, which is relatively flat in terms of topography. So I don't think there's going to be a whole lot of energy taken out of this. A lot of times when these tropical systems move over land, they're away from their primary power source, that warm ocean water. That will not be the case for very long with this particular situation. So we do anticipate, and so does the National Hurricane Center, that this storm will gain a bit of strength. And as we show you the forecast path, notice this, moving to the northwest, then gaining strength to a Category 4 storm. Winds of 135 miles an hour. That should be the situation if this forecast plays out for Sunday. Then we're going to continue onward as we go from Sunday and into Monday at 8 o'clock in the morning. Winds of 125 miles an hour, weakening just a little bit. And then back into, we go into parts of Sunday, rather from Monday into Tuesday, coming on shore either as a Category 1 or Category 2 storm. Again, just passing to the west of New Orleans, but you got to remember, the strongest winds, the heaviest storm surge, a lot of the damage could be on the eastern side of this, which would certainly be in the range of New Orleans. And then it should move inland, again, as I mentioned, away from its primary power source and dying down to a tropical storm as we get into Wednesday. A couple things to think about. You look at this big cone behind me. That's the cone of uncertainty. The storm could move a little bit more to the east. Perhaps it could jog to the west. Any type of bump, any skip the storm could move early in its path, maybe crossing over Cuba, could make a difference in terms of hundreds of miles as to where the storm might end up. So the only way you can really stay on top of it is just to watch it, monitor it. That's what we're going to do here at CNN. So for the very latest in your weather situation, stay here at CNN, where you're hurricane headquarters, and we're a full team. I'm just here in the weather area, but of course out in the field, and both of you at the news desk. Let's send it back to you guys.
Okay, thank you, Reynolds.
You bet, guys. And we have been talking about today, everything's going on in New Orleans, other evacuations in place. We've also been telling you about the airport that is going to shut down there at 6 p.m. tomorrow on Sunday. But certainly a mess there right now. We assume a lot of people trying to get out. Our Don Lemon on the phone there at the airport in New Orleans. Don, I don't know if you're just getting there, if you're trying to get out, so tell us what your situation is and what the situation is at the airport.
Hey, TJ, just getting into the airport. Got in, I guess, about 30 minutes ago and immediately noticed a difference in what is happening here. I'm seeing lots of military people, some folks with guns, lots of people in uniform from the Air Force to the National Guard to the Army. They're all here. I happen to hook up with the person who's in charge of the operations for getting all the evacuees out by planes. He's standing here with me now. I'm going to let him talk to you in just a little bit. But what they're telling me here is that the initial plan is for the airport to close at 6 o'clock. But depending on the weather, it could close earlier or it could close later. Or if something happens and the storm doesn't come this way, it may not close at all. But what they're, which is very interesting, they're chartering aircraft from airlines, every different airline, as many as they can get, depending on, you know, what's in service and what's not, to try to get people out. Initially, they want to get people out by bus and then by rail, and then the last round of getting people out will be done by air. So what they've done is chartered all those aircraft, as many as they can, to get people out. If they can't get enough people out by rail and by bus. So Bullet Young is on the phone now doing...